Penguin Random House Audio presents Fatherish. Laugh out loud tales from a dad trying not to ruin his kids' lives. This is the author, Clint Edwards. To Pikachu, the family dog. The kids wanted to name you Fart Squirrel. I objected. You're welcome. I kinda suck at this. In 2019, I was interviewed on an international TV show about how I manage screen time limits with my children. They presented me as a parenting expert, something I find unsettling for a few reasons, the most pressing being that the title of my blog is No Idea What I'm Doing. The interview was on Skype. I did it in my upstairs closet because it was the cleanest room in my house, but it was a big closet, and my hope was that they'd assume I had a home office, which I don't. I was also in my underwear. Okay, hold the phone. Perhaps that's misleading. I just didn't see the point in wearing pants if no one was going to see below my waist, so I tucked my shirt into my underwear and refused to stand for anything. The real question is, am I wearing pants right now? Well, just don't ask me to stand up. Deal? To make matters worse, the TV show also left out the part where I mentioned that all of the good ideas I presented about managing screen time weren't mine at all. They were my wife's. What I'm trying to get at here is that although I was presented as a parenting expert for a few hot minutes on international TV, I wasn't. I'm not. I probably never will be. I was just some dude trying to conceal all of his family's messes by hiding in his closet, which seems like an overarching metaphor for parenting in the 21st century, don't you think? A few years ago, my wife, Mel, and I paid for pictures. The photographer took us to this very nice little bridge next to a stream in the Oregon woods. It was fall, and all three of our children left the van in adorable matching white and blue outfits, their hair combed just right. The sun was setting. It was the magic hour. We were there for who knows how long, fighting with our kids, giving them those bloodshot, silent, angry eyes that only parents get during family pictures, trying to get them to stop shoving dead leaves in their dress clothes. I got so flustered, I had an emotional aneurysm. Something broke in my head. I think it was my sanity, or maybe my soul. At one point, I tried to put our toddler, Aspen, on my shoulders for a picture, and she kicked me in the face. Have you seen Ant-Man? When the hero shrinks down to the size of an ant, he can still punch with the power of a 200-pound man. I'm not sure of the science, but that kick to the face made me wonder if my daughter was actually Ant-Man. My lip started bleeding and everything. Out of the hundreds of pictures we took before the sun went down, we ended up with only one decent picture. A very adorable shot in which Aspen was looking up at her older sister Nora with admiration. I posted it on my blog's Facebook page, and it received hundreds of comments about how cute my kids were, and people complimented me on how good of a father I was. I couldn't help but notice the irony as I read through these comments with a bag of frozen peas on my lower lip. I regularly get messages from people who follow me on social media telling me I'm a great dad. They ask me for advice on their marriage and raising their kids as if I'm some sort of an expert. And every single time it happens, I look at the message and feel like a fraud. I don't know if this is imposter syndrome or what. I suppose it could be a lot of things, but one thing I know for sure is that I fail a lot as a father. Not that I don't have good ideas. I do. It's just that they often come out sideways. I've written about parenting for the New York Times and the Washington Post. I've been presented as an expert on The View and the Kelly Clarkson Show and the Today Show and Good Morning America. And it's all a total sham because I sort of suck at this. I started this parenting thing in 2007. Or was it 2006? Wow, I feel like I'm at the doctor's office and they asked about my kids' birthdays. It doesn't matter, because I've been at this for a while. I've done some really boneheaded things raising Tristan, Nora, and Aspen. I don't think any of them have been illegal, but definitely questionable and highly relatable. I cannot be alone here. I think all parents have been living a normal life, doing their normal parenting thing, and bam, the sex talk happens. Or you think you've got it figured out, and suddenly you find your children's booger collection. Or you spend all day planning a wonderful birthday party and everything goes to hell, and somehow, as you are sitting there questioning your life choices, your child goes on and on about how awesome their party was, and you are left wondering if maybe you are only half bad at this parenthood thing. Failure is a huge part of being a parent. Sometimes you fail and learn a lesson. Sometimes fails are fails, and nothing really good comes from them. But you try again tomorrow. Sometimes you feel like a failure, only to realize it was all in your head and you actually nailed it. Failure is a natural part of parenting, and that is a fact that everyone online is trying desperately to hide. Come on now. Admit it. You didn't post about that time you lost it with your kids because they wouldn't get in the shower, or wouldn't let you sleep, or wouldn't stop asking for screen time, or kept arguing over whose fart smelled the worst, so you angry whispered at them. But you really wanted to scream until you realized it was summer and all the windows were open and the neighbors would hear. We are all like some dude in his closet doing a Skype interview on international TV, trying to look like an expert when in fact he's wearing a collared shirt and no pants. There are no parenting experts. I know this is a difficult notion to accept, considering everyone online presents themselves all put together with their quality pictures of smiling children with clean faces and well-organized rooms in the background. But that's all fake news, people. Behind each and every one of those pictures is a parent flipping their biscuits because their children won't stop shoving dead leaves in their pants. So here's what I'm going to do in this book. I'm going to put myself out there. I'm going to tell a few stories where I didn't shine all that brightly as a father. I'm going to overreact and underreact. At times, I will embellish and exaggerate, getting lost in my own fears or getting too excited when I should have been grounded, all of it causing me to say, think, or do something stupid. But please realize in between these essays are a million moments where I shined so brightly as a dad, it would have given you a farmer's tan. Parenting is a huge gamble, and the possibility of 100% success is unlikely. Learn from my mistakes, and don't be surprised when you see a lot of yourself in these stories. And with that, I'm going to end this introduction with a hard truth. Failing, but not giving up, day after day until your children begin to resemble functioning adults, really is the purest form of love. Special Occasion Fails. When Santa Threatened My Children. I came into the kitchen late Saturday morning to find Tristan, my 6-year-old son, on my cell phone. When I asked who he was talking to, he looked me dead in the eyes, holding the phone to his ear with his right hand, and said with fierce conviction, "Santa." It was midday, and his face was pale, a mix of shock and anger. I heard my old high school buddy John speaking on the other end of the line. He was grunting some. I didn't 100% know what had just happened until I took the phone from Tristan. I spoke with John for a moment as Tristan watched. He was wearing black and yellow.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.